Welcome to Reality Creative Video. I'm Hermes. Today we're going to learn how to make sodium citrate without mold from scratch using lemon powder and baking soda. If you've watched the previous videos on this, you'll know why, but just in case you're watching this video for the first time and didn't see the others, it's because this is citric acid, which is a part of sodium citrate. Sodium citrate is made from baking soda and citric acid. But guess what? Citric acid is not made from lemons. It's made from mold that's grown on lemons. It's not exactly the same thing. And the problem with the mold on the lemon is their people are allergic to it. Not to mention, the healthiness of citric acid grown from mold is really questionable at this time. So what's the solution? Clearly the easy solution is we're going to make our own sodium citrate. But it's not as easy as it seems. You just can't mix lemon juice powder and baking soda together and say, ooh, I got sodium citrate. There's other magic that has to go on there in order to create the sodium citrate. But so in order to get rid of the mold, we gotta make our own. And I've been working really hard on how to do that over the last few weeks. This here in this bottle is the final product of it. It's sodium citrate, about 1.47 grams of sodium citrate. It's at the concentration of the sodium citrate that I use for my colloidals. But you can easily up the concentration and use it for cooking and things like that. So, but let's focus on making the sodium citrate first, show you guys how the process is, because it's a little bit, there's some steps involved. All right, so first things first, we're going to need baking soda and you're going to need lemon juice powder. All right, I've used organic lemon juice powder. Now, the problem with lemon juice powder, okay, is that citric acid, let's say citric acid is at a strength of 100. Lemon juice powder has citric acid at the strength of 20. So what that means is it takes 8 times more lemon powder to produce the same amount of citric acid. Probably another reason why they go the mold route. So the other problem with it is lemon powder is variable in the amount of citric acid it contains. It can be variable in the various powders that are in here, and it could be variable between brands and variable between if I bought this 3 weeks from now, I might get a different concentration of citric acid. So we have to come up with a way to know that we got the right amount of citric acid when we mix it together. This is where it starts to get a little dicey. All right. So first, what we're going to do is you're going to need a kitchen scale. This is a kitchen scale, cheap kitchen scale. It's not one of my 4-digit or 3-digit, laboratory scales. Just a regular kitchen scale. This thing, if you've never seen this before, is called a weigh boat. You can get them on Amazon, but you can use a dish too. And what you want to do is you're going to turn on your scale, all right, and then you're going to put the weigh boat on there, and then you're going to tear it out, make it zero. And then we're going to start weighing our powders out. And the first powder, I'm going to show you, I did a video of doing the baking soda, okay? 1.3 grams of baking soda. We're going to make 100 milliliters of this stuff just to start to show you how to do it. You can certainly make more if you want to or less. Well, that's what we're going to start with. And we're going to use distilled water. Anyway, so there's the video that's playing now of putting the powders in and getting my stuff. So then we're going to, once we got our powders all mixed up, all right, this is 8 grams. I've measured this. This is 8 grams of lemon powder. This is 1.3 grams of baking soda. Now, this may look like an impressive amount of lemon powder, but let me tell you, the citric acid in this is quite weak, and citric acid by itself is also a very weak acid. So this little bit of baking soda is extremely powerful in a sense of, even though we got all this extra stuff here, this baking soda is 8 times more powerful than this, or more. I'm just guessing at that. So anyway, we're going to take 100 milliliters of water, and we're going to put it in a beaker. So, and then we're going to pour in the baking soda, and we're going to mix this up until there is absolutely nothing left of the baking soda. It may take a little while for the baking soda to dissolve in the beaker. There you go. All right. And now we're going to do the fizzy test. And I'm going to show you a video of the fizzy test. And the fizzy test, we're going to take our 8 grams of powder, of lemon juice powder, and we're going to start adding it here like this. And I'll show you the video that zooms in on the fizzy test. And you're going to see that the stuff is fizzing. And then you're going to mix each, you're going to put a gram, you could put a gram, you know, this is a half a teaspoon I'm doing here. Basically, you'll put a gram in at a time, and then you're going to mix and mix and mix. And this may take a little while to mix up. You get completely mixed up. And let's make sure you completely mix it up between each gram that you put in here, or half a gram if you want to go more slowly. Make sure it's completely mixed up in here before you go and put in the next lemon poop powder that fizzes up. And you're going to repeat this, and you're going to keep watching it, and the fizziness is going to start to decrease after you get enough in there. Now, again, it depends on your lemon powder. This lemon powder needs 8. In order for the fizzy to stop. Once the fizziness stops, when you can drop the powder in and it's no longer fizzing, you stop. For me, that's 8 grams of this particular lemon juice powder. I had a friend, Jimmy, who has been working with me, one of the subscribers here, great help. He's been doing this at home as well. And his lemon juice powder comes in at 6 grams before the fizzy stops. And this is the thing, the inconsistency in the lemon powder. In order to make real sodium citrate, you have to neutralize all the carbon dioxide out of the baking soda. And then you're left with real sodium citrate. So once that's done, you'll have a little bit more than what we started with 100 milliliters. You will have 1.47 grams of sodium citrate dissolved in this liquid. Now, we're not done yet with the process, okay? Now, the problem is there are organic elements in the lemon juice powder, and they can start to grow things in your colloidals. So, it's not so much of a problem in cooking. Of course, you're just going to make up what you need for cooking. I'll talk about cooking in a little bit. But for colloidals, we need to sterilize it. So, you're going to take your lemon juice sodium citrate that you just made, and you're going to boil it for about 3 to 5 minutes. All right, now what I would recommend is, you know, I had put this in the microwave, which was a really wrong thing to do, because it boiled out all over the place. So you're going to want to pour that stuff into a bigger beaker, like something like this, throw it in the microwave, and let it boil for a few minutes, at least 3 minutes, and then you're going to put back the fluid that's missing. So you'll have to, if it's down 20 milliliters because you boiled it, you'll need to add 20 milliliters of distilled water to bring it back up to the 100 milliliter range, so that we are at the concentration we need for our colloidals. And then it will be sterilized. And it will change color. It'll go from clear to this color. And it may even change color over the next few days. Yes, this is one I made up. I made up a few about a week or two ago. You see the color is different. So it may actually change color. That's okay. Nothing wrong with that. It's just it's citric acid reacting. So that gives us sodium citrate without mold. And as you can see, it's a little bit tricky. Now, I talked about where you could use this for cooking. And, you know, you could do the same thing with cooking, but you actually don't have to use 100 milliliters of liquid to do it. I'm using 100 milliliters of liquid to do it for our colloidals so that we have a base, something that we can use when we mix it with our colloidals. And when we're making colloidal gold, we need normally 10 milliliters of sodium citrate to mix with our colloidal gold to give us a ruby red. That's another problem here, and I'm not going to cover that in this particular thing because I don't know yet what it is. This concentration of sodium citrate is not exactly the same because of the lemon juice in here. It affects the gold formula. It doesn't necessarily affect the copper formula, but it affects the gold formula and getting the ruby red. So I've had to add 20 milliliters instead of 10 milliliters of this sodium citrate made from lemon juice in order to get ruby red. But I have to reconfirm that, okay? And I will post something about it. But if you want to experiment, you might have to use more or less to get your ruby red color from gold. That's the only tricky one. All the other colloidals are going to be fine. You just follow my directions in the other colloidals and substitute this citric acid, sodium citrate, instead of the store-bought mold sodium citrate for making the other colloidals. But for cooking, okay? Cooking, you can use less liquid in cooking, all right? But you have to look at the recipe and see how much you need. Like, if you need 3 grams of sodium citrate, then you're going to have to make more. You're going to have to use twice the amount of baking soda and twice the amount of lemon powder to get 3 grams of sodium citrate. And then you have to look at the recipe to see how much water you can take away, because you're making a liquid sodium citrate. We're not making a solid sodium citrate. So every 100 milliliters of this stuff, of this formula, that a base formula I do, will produce 1.47 grams of sodium citrate. Now, you could have that dissolved in 40 milliliters of liquid. That's fine. And what you do with your cooking is you will decrease the amount of liquid in your cooking appropriately. So if your cooking calls for, 100 milliliters of milk or something like that, so you want to decrease the milk a little bit just to make room for the liquid sodium citrate, because most recipes call for powder sodium citrate. And then you should be fine. It tastes the same. It has the same tart taste. I've checked it out. This has the same tart taste as the regular sodium citrate. And with cooking, it's about the taste and about the texture. That's why they use this stuff. But you can experiment with it. This video is basically on how to make your own sodium citrate without the mold in it. So that's about it. I hope I've told you enough that you can get this done on your own. If not, leave me comments and I will answer them. We need a second video on it because I didn't go through it well enough for you. I will do that. I'm Hermes, Reality Creative Video, Alchemy. Hey, talk to you again soon. And thanks for visiting and subscribing. And don't forget, recommend the channel to my friends. I'm still shooting for 1,000 subscribers. I gotta reach that. Bye.